Big Shot Bowling. Big Shot Bowling is brought to you by Jetty Ford. From Economy to Luxury, you'll find it at Jetty Ford. By Diamond Chevrolet, where you always get a diamond of a deal. By McGregor Sports, the leader in sporting equipment. And by Pet Vitamins, America's number one vitamin for dogs and cats. Big Shot Bowling is brought to you in conjunction with the World Hamilton Bowlers Congress. Hi, everybody. Bob Foraker with Dan the Man Murphy here on Big Shot Bowling. And as always, it's our pleasure to have you with us for exciting Hamilton Bowling. The defending champ is back, Don Richmond. He has won three in a row, and he'll be taking on a guy from Southridge, Mass., Harry Reno. Could be, hopefully will be a good one, Dan.
Well, on paper, they certainly look like they could have a great match, but we'll see if they both brought the best bowling with him. And, of course, he's trying to make it three in a row. Don Richmond beat a great one last week in Charlie Milan. This week, Harry Reno.
Let's take a close-up of Harry Reno from Southridge, Massachusetts.
Yeah, Harry comes in averaging 128, has a high single of 204, and a high three of 475. He qualified for the show with a 663.
And he's been in the winner's circle before. He's won six here on Big Shot Bowling, and he'll be taking on a guy who overall, since 1987, has been a champ nine times, and here he is, Don Richmond.
Okay, and as we said the last few weeks, Don comes in averaging 123. High single of 199, a high triple of 510. Amazing.
510. I can't count that high.
Yeah, I know. I noticed. That's why I'm here going.
Thank you, Dad. We'll be back with the first three. But before we do, we're going to break for these messages right now here on Big Shot Bowling. Again, everybody, welcome back to Big Shot Bowling. Bob Foraker with Dan Murphy. Lead it off, we got Harry Reno. Harry Reno taking on our three-time present champ and Don Richmond. A few weeks ago, Steve Reno, the son of Harry, was on here, and he came up shorthanded to Jim Putnam. Harry lifted off with a nine. Harry Reno on lane number 30 with an average of a 128. Well, it's going to get a break with the 6 and 10 going down. Leaves himself just a 1-2-4. Good break for not hitting the edge end off. It happens once in a while. Let's see if Harry takes advantage of it. He does.
He does.
First mark of the match off the bowling of Harry Reno. Here's the champ, Don Richmond. The winner of this show will receive a couple of $100. And the runner-up, $100. The winner of each string will grab an extra 25. And both men leading it off with nine. Last week, it was Richmond winning out over Charlie Milan the third. He had a 400. Charlie's disappointing 334. And the week before, Dan, John had a win not as high, 349.
That's right. Similar shot that Harry just had, but the opposite side, 136.
And
got it. Doesn't get it the way Harry did. He plays it on the outside. A little pin action off the right sidewall to knock out the six. You see the replay off the wall, and finally the six goes down.
Harry, big one,
gone.
Yeah, got him. Best of all, goodbye. Strike on the clear.
1-2 pocket for Harry that time for that strike. Harry went from walking across, looking for two in a row.
Close. All but the three, pins.
fires. Nine on the strike after a strike on the spare. And a 10 to the disgust of Harry Reno. 58 after four. Don working on a mark. Short, fast to see that just the timing wasn't there. They're releasing the ball out in the lane. They released it pretty close to just about the foul line. Oh!
Right back.
Wow, climbs all over him. Made the correction there. Got that ball out in the lane. A superlative spare right here. Fills it with seven. 3-6-7 left. Both bowlers will be leaving here with trophies from George Girt Trophy Center located in Worcester, Massachusetts. When thinking trophies, thinking awards, please no further than Girt Trophy Center. They're located at 138 Southford Street in the fine city of Worcester. Bob Zanotti and Paul Gully there to serve you.
Wow! Whoa!
There goes the three pin. And nothing else.
There he's still far with a spare and a strike. Comes right back with a strong one. Out of 10. The midway point of the first game, it's the 68 for Harry Reno. Oh, nice one. Got them all.
Really mixing the pins up when he's in that 1-2 pocket. That was nice and tight, though. Like, almost pulling the head pin. Just glances off into the 1-2 pocket, and just another time before the 5 pin goes.
Two strikes, one spare for Reno. There's Richmond. Oh, right in the 1-3 pocket, leaving the 7.
Had the spare to see that last 3 weeks quite a few times.
Last week, Don had 4 strikes, 11 spares and moved to his win. 21st one, some 3 weeks ago, he defeated Bill Hart. He carved out a 3-string count of a 4-10 over Hart. 324. Oh my. Is it going to happen? Nope. The 6 is still there. Don with 3 spares, hoping to make it 4.
Pulled the lead 1-10 of Harry. Black pulled ahead of Harry by 1. 69-68 through 5. Both bowlers, as you see. One has a strike, Harry, and Don has a spare in the 6. So far, both bowlers living up to the top billing we gave them, Bob.
Hit the top of the show.
Oh, wow. It's a double for Harry.
Looking for the big-time Emma gift if he gets a strike right here. 3 strikes, 1 spare for Harry Reno. He's going for the triple. There it is. No. Since the show started in 1985, we've had a few triples, one four-bagger, and that four-bagger by Dan Gallant, and people with triples, Jack Ray had a couple, Mike Sargent, Paul Wombach, Gallant the four-bagger, Rosario Lacerda, Olsa, Ottoman, Carrington, Prefel, Jernicke, Surratt, and Lacerda.
How many is that, Dan? About 12 or so?
No?
Sure.
Whatever. A 123 with 2 to go in the first for Harry Reno.
I can't count that, huh?
It's 12.
Yeah, 12. Something like that.
Don Richmond, a disappointing 3 on his spare. Truly, three on the spare and eight boxes, 21 through those two frames of six and seven, so the spare really didn't help him that much.
No, and he's down by 23 at this juncture of the match.
Went from one pin ahead after five to 23 pins behind after seven. With the double strike is what helped Harry Reno. Triangle, 3-5-6 left for Don Richmond. See if he can get it. Nope, good off to the left. Don Richmond with an average of a 123. Best single, 199. Best triple, a 510. Down to the final two in the first. Harry Reno leading it by 23. 123 to an even 100 for the champ, Don Richmond. Harry sits down eight, leaves himself to three and a five. Looks good. No.
It looked good to me again.
I was saying, what lane are you watching?
I was watching.
Harry knew he missed it as soon as he let the ball go.
It looked good. It was a perfect time.
Harry threw his hands up like, oh, I missed it.
He four out of
ten. Looks good.
No. A 133 with one to go for Harry. This one looks good. It looks good for, let's see, 610.
Almost missed that by an acre.
How about 4 acres? Oh, my God. So nice to have you aboard here on Big Shot Bowling.
Well, thank you, Bob. You're the viewers, though.
Oh. Tony Jernicke is the head official, and D.C. is going down to check things out.
Tony C. He's also the clerk and tournament director of the World Canelpin Bowlers Congress, their pro tour. Also working the show, our statistician, Dottie Lurick. And keeping the scoreboard that you see on your screen is Cheryl Young. I'm Bob Foraker, my partner's Dan Murphy. And we're here at Londonderry Bowling Center in Londonderry, New Hampshire. And a 10 and a 143 for Harry in the first game. We'd like to give a special thanks to Sally Reed, the manager of Londonderry Bowling Center. Does such a great job, he and his staff, hosting Big Shot Bowling. Right through the middle is Don Richmond, 1, 5, and 8. I'd like to get at least one mark out of these two. Get a little closer.
Oh, yeah, that's a great try.
That looked good, Bob.
Oh, did it ever.
And you know what looks good? Formal wear from Mr. Tuck. That's right, they suited me up for this show, and they gave me a new timber bum or whatever. What?
You got it.
Yeah, Mr. Tuck. They're the formal wear specialist located in Worcester and in Natick. Gary A. Levine, the formal wear specialist, and Mark Atkins. We thank them both. Next time you want to go bowling and you want formal wear, go see Mr. Tuck.
I hope he doesn't come from New Hampshire because he doesn't give me anything.
Nice one. Got the bucket, kicked it over for the spare. Or the diamond, whichever you prefer. He got it. A 120 plus the ball's going, and Harry Reno got the first 25 in his pocket.
His strike come within 13.
An 8 drop, and a 15. So we had an exciting first game showcasing the champ, Don Richmond, and the challenger, Harry Reno. Here's the scoreboard, a 143 to a 128. We'll be back with the second, but first, let's roll away. The Travel Couriers International, they're located in Northville, Massachusetts. And of course, they have a big trip coming up to Ireland. If you'd like to go to Ireland in November of 1991 and see the Holy Cross Crusader football team in action against the Rams of Fordham University, you can call Travel Couriers International at 1-800-642-2530. The Sherry family making your travel arrangements for that big trip to Ireland to see Holy Cross and Fordham in November of 1991. The action will take place at Limerick Stadium in Limerick, Ireland. Limited seats available, so call now. Travel Couriers International, the Sherry family, would like to bring you over to that
big ball game. And here we go with this big match. Danny, have you ever been to Ireland?
No, I haven't.
But, well, maybe you can win the trip.
Oh, big strike.
Guess what, Danny?
No replay?
No replay.
No. Yeah, Tim is having
some coffee break.
There must be something in the contract.
Yep.
A strike in the first box, there is no,
no replay.
Replay.
Going for the double. You've seen one, you've seen them all. You know what I mean?
Well, no, not necessarily, Bob. I've seen, you know.
Well, I was trying to get him out of a game.
Oh, I see.
But I guess you're right. They all don't look alike.
Don Richmond shows no signs of catching the PR flu. You know what that is, don't you, Bob?
Yeah, once you take a break, you go to PR's tavern and
right. Yeah, usually, everyone knows you take five shows in a day, and you usually take three and break for lunch and grab some PR's tavern food and beverage, and sometimes put the flu in there. They come out, they don't bowl as well. Don is doing quite well.
Here's a very easy lead. The one, the seven, the eight, and then is that the nine back here?
Oh, Bob,
that's why I'm here.
Oh.
Or is that
it's
the seven?
One, the six, seven, and
I know. I just wanted to see if you could tell from way back here.
I didn't even got my glasses with me and I can see that, Bob. I just watched the monitor. This is what they put the
ship. Hey, here's a nine for Harry Reno,
must be a nine, so I'll just put it on the scoreboard.
Yep. It's going to be now. It's in the book. It's irreversible. Just like fans out of Missouri found out when they played Colorado in football this year. Long live the Buffaloes of Colorado over Missouri.
Oh, boy. Yeah. Hey,
irreversible.
Fans, we got the fans.
I know we got them out there.
Joe Pickler and his buddies out there.
Elvin, Missouri.
And here you show me space.
Picking on them.
They're going to be out here next taping, I'm telling you. We got some big fellows there at the Sunset Lane, too. I'm glad they're my buddies.
Don Richmond right back in the pocket. This time an eighth drop on the stair. Giving 38 for two. Second game opened with a 125, 128.
Okay.
Oh, he's got to hurry
up.
That one did not look good. Richmond with a strike and six spares in the match. And a 10 after opening up with a strike spare. John E. Liggins is the man we salute right now. John is the executive producer of Big Shot Bowling and the president of Six Gun Productions. And John's goal is to bring love and world peace through the foot of Pendleton Bowling.
Another mark for Don Richmond in the fourth.
Richmond. Let's see now. Where is he? Is he in the driver's seat?
Oh, he was.
Yeah.
I think he's in the front seat right now. He's still in the passenger seat.
Well, now he just... I think he's taking over the driver's seat.
He's taking over the driver's seat.
No, they're both driving.
Yeah, he's in seat.
Scotty Orrick is giving us the lowdown.
You
know, all the other smut that goes on, you know,
yeah.
In the bowling world. He knows it all.
Scotty knows it all.
Yeah. He's the finest.
Yep.
Yeah, Dottie is right now in the rumble seat. And we don't know who's in the driver's seat. You remember those rumble seats, Dan?
No, Bob, I don't.
Neither do I. I read about them.
Oh, no.
Yo, bro.
You swung 3-6, and I thought he covered. That looked good going down.
Oh, did it ever. Did it ever. And a 10 count for Harry Reno, 41 after 4, and a 58 with the ball working for Don before he closes out his fourth in the second game.
And he has taken over the driver's seat now.
Yep. Up by 17 in this one, and adding to it right here. And in the match, he was up by a handful. Now he's up, more than a handful now. Oh, nice try by Don Richmond.
looking for his fourth straight and overall his 10th victory here on Big Shot Bowling, dating back to 1987. Oh, there's that replay we missed in the first frame on that strike.
I just heard the people screaming and hollering at home. They wanted to see that replay.
They
that
was, did. They did.
Yeah,
that was very important.
Wood in front of that single pin. That was, you know,
it meant a lot. Let's see now. Going for a single. That is what?
The four pin.
Yeah.
That's right. I can see it now.
He's on it. He's got it. John can see it. Oh, Johnny gets himself another spare. He has three spares, one strike in this game. Eight spares, one strike overall in the match. And Harry brings down eight, looking down at the three and the six. Hoping to mark. Yes, sir.
He's got quite a match on his hands.
Yes, we do.
Some big totals today. 51 through 5 with a ball coming. Get some of those pins back. Well, let's see. 6, 7, 7. 1, 4, 7 left.
I'm sure Harry would have liked the 2 to stand and get a shot at the 1, 2, 4, 7. We're going to be taking a break right after this frame. And at 8. And a 6 after a 6 as we go to the scoreboard. And a 8. McGregor, tennis, archery, skiing, volleyball, ping pong, McGregor, bowling, McGregor. Yes, it's number one, McGregor. So now let's get down to lane number 29.
Because that's not McGregor,
that's Richmond. Richmond, McGregor. No, Don Richmond. Working on a spare in the fifth. In the 1-3 pocket, tips over a half dozen. Like that game, tips over a half dozen.
I know. That's pretty good, Bob. Wait for a superlative shot.
Wait for this call. That half, what was renamed?
Nah, it's not that bad. Nah. You gotta work on that one.
Yeah, first side.
You haven't been excited yet in these matches either.
Yeah.
Kind of mellowing out.
Well, you know, the captain's still in Cambodia with his fiance. I don't know. I'm a little down, I guess, but I'll get up. We've got a great match here, so there's no reason to be down. When you're up, you're down. When you're upside down, when you're up against Richmond, you're upside down. How does that feel, though?
I don't know, Bob.
Neither do I.
Going out with the rumble seat.
Yeah. When you're up 5, 8, 9, and 10.
You just had a pinch to 5 on the left-hand side. You see what happens.
Oh, just yeah! Like wow, what a pinch! Oh, good call, Dan. Oh, man. Did you hear that, folks? Dan, pinch it, man. That he did. Watch this. Yes, sir. Oh, nice call, Dan.
Thanks, Bob. Means a lot coming through.
I know it does.
I think he just lost something on the lane here. I think the bowler's button might have just been tailed on lane 30. That thing's rolling around on the lane.
Wow. Tony Zernike has everything under control.
That's when Harry tries to reset this machine. He's going to find a little surprise. The button's not there, folks.
No, Harry, look out, baby.
Half whisker. Harry just kicked the button.
button.
Better than kick the bucket. He doesn't know where to go. No, he doesn't know what to do with the button. He just thought that there was no button there to push. So this could be
systematic in his young career. Harry, we know from Southbridge, Massachusetts. Or is that Southbridge?
Southbridge.
Oh,
trying to push the button, but it's not there.
No.
Oh, my.
Where is it?
Where's the button? Can we get a picture of Harry, please?
Look at the replay.
Yeah, where is the button?
Let's have a replay on this, Ken.
Unbelievable.
Only on Big Shot Bowling. How'd it go, Harry?
He can bowl. He's a mechanic. Unbelievable.
Oh, my.
These Candleman bowlers can do everything.
They can do it all.
They can do it all.
There it is. The replay.
Let's replay.
Curly and Moe.
They could have carried a little further because you get the little twisting action of putting the button on. That was a great shot. They don't miss a trick.
No. Great crew. Kicks on the square for Richmond. Richmond trying to run away and hide.
That's a good turnaround by Richmond. Now, Richmond was trailing coming into this one by 15. Reno had a 143, Richmond a 128, but here in the second, John has been on fire. Four fairs, one strike. Rivera has come up with a couple of strikes. There's two balls. Remember we went over before the show, Bob?
Oh, I'm sorry.
There's two strikes and one ball. You caught the T.I. flu.
And I didn't even win yet. I've been banned from T.I.
Whoa, man. Good form, though.
Follow through.
Harry, got them all. Home run ball. It's floated by Harry Reno, the challenger.
And we have a replay.
Not the score.
Oh, look at this. Great replay. Oh, picked over that four pin.
Harry now with a strike and two spares here in the second. In the first, he had three strikes and one spare.
Oh. Oh, and that's 16 for Gus. Just left the 10. That was a big miss right there.
And a 10. And a total as we go to the board of a 112 in the second. The champ, Don Richmond, posting a 135. And after two, a 263 to a 255. We'll be back with the third. But first, let's break for these messages.
These children need financial support, and we need your help. And we're asking you, just like Health System Production, WCDC, has been doing it for years, we'd like to ask you for your help. So sit down after the show, write us a check, send it to New England Medical Center, Chair of the Center for Children with Special Needs, 750 Washington Street, Boston, Massachusetts, 02111. Thank you, Dan, for those kind words. And now let's get back to Candleman Bowling. I'd like to thank John Liggins and Ann Liggins for doing such a great job with the floating hospital in Boston and the Center for Children with Special Needs. And then also, tip of the fedora to WCDC for being 100% pounded. Oh, my, nice one. We're into the final game, and Harry Reno. He gets himself a spare. You notice they can get the spare, but they can't get the strike.
I noticed that. They replay spares. There must be something in the contract. I don't understand.
He will give us some answers, I'm sure.
Harry now with 4-4. Four strikes, four spares. And coming into this one, Harry was trailing by 8. 263 to a 255. Reno on the minus side of the scoreboard after a couple. Third is after 2 in the final. It's a 22 for Harry. A disappointing 4 on the spare. Oh, mighty fine ball, all but one. Don looking for his fourth straight win here on his shot.
Only 18 separate both bowlers after two games, so long way to go. Third and final game.
Got it for the mark. 11 marks now for Richmond. 10 spares, one strike.
Well, just stays on the lane also.
Let's see if he can better the four that Harry has. Yeah, he does, and then some. Beats it by 5 as he drops 9.
And he's going to try to tip over the 5-pin for another mark.
This is a lead to 13, and if you hurt this, he'll increase it even more next time up.
Got it. So Harry's going to put some offense up. All offense in this one, baby. In most sports, defense wins ball games, offense sells tickets, but here you're going to have all these big O, right?
Credit, Bob.
I'm right on the money again, actually, man.
You're incredible.
I missed the superlative, that's why. Doesn't get any better than that, does it? Yo-ho! Look out! No. Whoa, Nelly. Hold on. It's going to be white knuckle time in a while.
I'm white knuckle nail biting time.
Yeah, white knuckle nail biting. Steve Swimmer, Bond Brenner. 85 the door. You've got it all, baby.
There's a determined look on that face. Harry Reno. Or Reno.
Reno, of course, and I know.
West of the Mississippi, they call it Reno.
Southridge, Reno, Northrow. Who knows what they call it?
We're going to think 17, Bob.
Yeah.
Let's see what he does with that.
Did some house cleaning down there. By the way, the winner picks up $200, and the guy who comes in second gets himself $100. And when you win a string, you win $25 here on Big Shot Bowling. And the champ also gets a chance to win himself a trip for two to Ireland, compliments of Travel Couriers. They're located, Travel Couriers International, I should mention. They're located in Northborough, Massachusetts. The Sherry family. Joe Sherry. Danny Sherry. And Joe Sherry Jr.
Wow.
4-1. For all your travel needs, it's TCI, Travel Couriers International in Northborough, Massachusetts.
That 1-6 keeps Harry Reno within 2 miles of Don Richmond. A decent throw, and he would have fallen at least 2 miles.
Wow! That was so good, I don't want to see it again.
No, I don't either, no.
No way. No, don't run the reach.
No, don't forget it, Tim.
Thank you, Tim. It was good, but, you know, it was... No, it was
just a superlative shot.
Yeah, that's right. Whoa! There's a
superlative strike.
Oh, yes. We got a good one brewing. And Harry Reno. On a lane 29, hoping to spare.
And he really needs this.
He does.
No.
Missed it by an inch. Missed it by another inch. One to the right, one to the left, 49 at the midway point of the final game for Harry. He has one mark there for John Richmond, who leads it by 18 and can climb, because when he gets up, he'll be working on a strike. John with 2 stairs and 1 strike here in the final.
Harry, all of a sudden, he's gone
cold.
He's gone south to Southridge.
He wants to go back home with a win. Looking for the double.
Now, he's in a 3-mark situation right now, depending on the film. He puts it close to 4, and he only has 4 boxes remaining, so he's going to have to almost mark out.
So it's a double strike where he's in trouble. He's in deep trouble now. Going for the triple coming up. Here it is, on replay.
A little black and white replay.
Well,
that's different stuff.
Yeah.
We're back live, living color.
Ah, went for the triple. Had he got it, he would have... Let himself an amateur.
Ooh, just pulling 6 on the second strike.
2 strikes, 2 sixes on the strike. Strike 6, strike 6. And an 8.
I think he's in a double strike situation.
Are we going to take a break right here? I believe we are. We're going to take a break. We're going to roll away. We almost lost again, but because of my brilliance, we did.
So we'll replay it, some house cleaning there, and whoops, they got a speaker under the rug. Didn't work. Just a little fun here on Big Shot Bowling. Back we come to the action. We're down to the final four. And Harry is trailing it by a whole bunch. 40 in the match, 32 in this game.
You probably have to explain what just happened to these guys in Missouri. Sunset Lane is in the lawn drinking. And what the heck is going on with Big Shot Bowling?
I asked the same thing and I'm here.
We set a pin in the channel we had to remove, fellas. Fellas, you listening, man? Sunset Lane? They're not listening.
No, they're not. They're partying.
They're partying in
Elgin, Missouri.
Yeah, they're partying. Wild crew.
They have never recovered from the football game when the Buffaloes beat them. Fair and square. Fair and square. Colorado beat Missouri. In football, fair and square.
Those zebras will beat the...
Harry, wish he was in Missouri right now.
Yeah.
I'm glad we're not.
Speak for yourself, Bob.
78.
I think I'd like...
We're so really nice. My favorite state is Colorado, other than Massachusetts and New Hampshire and New England, you know, Maine. Because they know how to play football.
Next phone call is going to be to you from these fellas.
Oh, Joe and the boys. Don Richmond hoping to pick up his fourth win in a row. And if he does, he will become the second guy with 10 victories. Oh, my. Nice one. Nice one. Big time shot. Big
superlative
shot.
Oh, yeah.
Superlative.
Yep, he's got that one right.
Icing on the cake now. That's fair replay.
Half dozen on the fair. Yeah, the guy with the most wins ever here on Big Shot Bowling, Peter Flynn with 15, followed by John Zernicke and Jack Ray with 11 apiece. Then it is Tom Surrett with 10, the guy you're watching today, Mr. Richmond with 9, along with Paul Berger, followed by Dan Gallant, who has grabbed 8 titles over the years. Well, we're down to the final 2 in the final game. Each guy has won a swing, each guy has pocketed 25. And it looks like Richmond is going to pocket a couple of 100 besides that. And another 25.
That's exactly what's going to happen. So Richmond's going to go on. Next week, we've got one of the higher throwers on the pro tour, Joe Ashline. Now from New Hampshire, he'll be in here to try to stop Don Richmond.
An 8 count, 86 with one to go for Harry Reno. Once again, we'd like to thank the executive producer of Big Shot Bowling, John Eagleton. And we'd also like to thank you for being with us. Stick around because Don Richmond is going to have a chance to win himself a trip to Tudor Island to see Holy Cross and Fordham play football in November of 1991. Compliments of Travel Couriers International. They're located in Northborough, Massachusetts. The Sherry family would love to bring you over to Ireland to see Holy Cross and Fordham. Give them a call. They'll tell you about all the details. There's limited seats available. So if you're interested, you better call now. Richmond up on lane 29. Opened up with a 128, then jumped to a 135. And of course, Harry ended up with a 96 after starting off with a 143. Dropping to a 112 and then dipping below that to a 96 for boosting count of a 351. On with a 125 with this brand new move. On with an average of a 123. Harry's average this year. Oh my, what a nice start. Harry had an average this year. I have an average this year of a 128. And I know he's disappointed. His high single was 202 and his high triple of a 475. Well, it's a just good stat for Carl. But Harry, you know, a fine bowler. He was a rookie on the tour here in 1981, won the state opens in 85 and the doubles in 87, the Pepsi Classic in 88, but he lost here today to Don Richmond. Don has just picked up his 10th win over the years here on Big Shot Bowling. His fourth in a row, and another 400 series bump. Yep, 407. There it is, ending up with a 144.
472, I think, isn't it?
407. Yeah, 407. We'll be back, and we'll see if Don Richmond can win a trip to Tudor Island to see Holy Cross and Fordham play football in November 1991. Compliments of Travel Couriers International in Northrop. A row now for the champ, Don Richmond, and he did it in fine fashion, 407 over Harry Reno.
Yeah, close match for two games, and then Don took back that third game, and another win.
Another win. Come on up, Harry. Let's have a nice round of applause for Harry Reno from Southbridge, Massachusetts, a past six-time champ here on Big Shot Bowling, but you didn't have it, and Don had it, and he gets the 200 plus, and you're going to get 100 plus a trophy and another 25.
Right. I was bowling good the first thing, and then I started having a lot of problems with my footing. I think I was thinking about it too much.
Well, that happens. You cannot think to yourself.
You can't do that against Don. You're going to blow your doors off.
I've never had that problem because most people know that I can't think. You see how
I can
think. Your downfall was when the button fell off. We had to repair the button.
I had to get up and ask.
Okay, Harry, let's have a nice round of applause for Harry. And now Don Richmond is going to go after a triple on a trip to Ireland, compliments of Travel Couriers International of Northrop. Let's see if he can get the triple, Dan, and a trip to Ireland. Here he goes. Hold on. Nope. He's going after an end, I guess.
Every time, Don.
Say that again.
Every time.
There he goes. Yo, come on over. Let's have a nice round of applause for the 10-time champ here on Big Shot Bowling. Don Richmond, you have now tied Tom Surrett with 10 victories. The overall leader is Pistol Peter Flynn with 50. You going to go after that?
Sure, why not?
Nice bowling.
Thank you. Well, as long as I can stay in that little groove, maybe I'll have a chance. But somebody else will come in with the same kind of groove, and who knows, you know? And I thought Harry was on it, the way he started out, and he fidgeted out a little bit, and I just kind of hung in there, and who knows.
Another trophy, $250, and trophy from Trophy Center in Worcester.
It was bigger than Harry, but this one's worth about $1,500.
Nice bowling.
Thank you, man.
What happened to DJ? Did he leave us?
He KO'd.
Well, you KO'd a few. Let's see if you can KO Joe Ashline next week. Bob Forrest at SV. Dan Murphy, our champ. Don Richmond, back to you. So much for being with us here on Big Shot Bowling. Inviting you back next week for more exciting action. Check it out.